You have lost a bit of timber, la, but you look good for it. Yes, I think I look all right when I stretch the old neck out. Because I was touch of a side of a house, you know what I mean? 18 stone of solid muscle. But I have lost a lot of muscle as well. I need to get that back, mainly between the ears. There we are. Would you go back to being a serious newsreader? Do you prefer to keep doing comedy? Do you know, Flying Norseman, this has been my problem, if you like. I love the light-hearted, funny approach because I see so much mirth and fun and goodness in life. And so many people just see badness all the time and negativity, and we won't have any of that. But I'm obviously getting a bit old now to be a staff newsreader, but it would still be nice to do a week or two and let the public see it. Say, my goodness, look who it is reading the news on the telly. Yes, indeed. And see if I could still do it. You know, can I still read an autocue? Because remember, when I started in television, there was no autocue. You had to do what was called the noddies. In fact, I think you can still see some of my early bulletins on YouTube. So do look it up. No time for negativity in this day and age. Do you know, Activision, we just don't. Because every second of life is precious. Every second. And if you get young people going, I'm bored. This is boring. I've been so boring. You know, you say to them, well, look, what is your problem? Because you're the luckiest, luckiest generation ever. There you are. You should go for it. Be a newsreader. Yes, I don't know. They might just laugh at me if I went along to the British Broadcasting Corporation. Give Trevor McDonald a run for his money. Dear Trevor, I've met him. Huge, big, tall man. Very elegant, very interesting man to speak to. Yes, indeed, the wonderful Trevor McDonald. Because I can remember when we said John Mackay, another fantastic newscaster, yes. Well, remember I was reading news in 1984. Now, that's not bad, is it? Money for the Tún of Dumfries, home of the Red Comyn. Red Comyn and the Comyn Riding and the Auld Brig. Do you know, I remember them rebuilding the Auld Brig, and there was a Dunhamer on here arguing that the Auld Brig's never been rebuilt. I said, you go back to about 1960. Aha! So there we are, the Nith. There we are. It was very dangerous looking. Seagulls perched on it. Yes, fantastic. I was four in 1960.